thank you for being here. It is fantastic to be here. I'm having a fantastic time listening to rock and roll. It is a wicked time in the week. We are now listening to, I got the wrong banner up. I'll change that right now because that will make editing a nightmare if I don't change it. Rolling Stones. Dude, sometimes I catch myself thinking, it's like, man, I really hope I'm like Keith Richards. Like, I just hope my body can take abuse. You know, like smoking and drugs and drinking and staying up late and working all day. And I really like to think that I'm like an Iron Man. I think I'm going to live to be an old man, even though I fucking destroyed my body. I respect the Rolling Stones, dude. And we've had this debate before, like Beatles or Rolling Stones. 6 months ago, I would have said Rolling Stones. But now I'm starting to be like, I got to lose my ego, bro. I gotta lose my ego about pop and listen to the Beatles, you know, because I think that I can learn something if I...
I'm going to request
I want to learn as much as I can about the Beatles and the Rolling Stones. I know a lot about the Rolling Stones, but the Beatles... Anyway, this is a brand new Rolling Stones. What is this, like a year old or something? Or this,
not even. This week it's or something? Like a couple weeks old.
Holy fuck. Brand new Rolling Stones. Let's see. These guys are the same age as my dad. I believe they're 77.
Yeah. How are they still putting out music? It's so crazy.
They're still touring because they do drugs all day. They must.
They're preserved. Well, very well preserved.
My big question in life is, what are the Rolling Stones doing to be able to withstand the abuse of drugs and alcohol for a whole life and still live to be old? Mm-hmm. They are the fountain of youth, bro. They get it. Whatever they're doing, I want to do it. You know, if they're whatever drugs they're doing, I want to do them. You know, like, I'm serious. Oh my God, that's hilarious. Let's get into their new song titled Angry. The Rolling Stones, brand new Rolling Stones. Hey, they're on drugs.
I like how happy it is.
Yeah, I'm singing about distressing things.
Yeah. It's a feel good tune. You know?
Yeah. This part doesn't sound like the Stones.
Yeah, I'm not.
The verses do. This part definitely does.
Right.
It's a blend, dude. They've done a good job becoming modern. And the solo is classic.
Such good feel to it.
So simple. It's amazing. This is a good dude. I love it.
It's like, how are they this old still putting out such a good song, you know?
Yeah, I know, it's crazy. It blows my mind. Don't be angry.
He sounds good, man.
Oh, it's fucking great. Wow. Dude, that is good. Dude, it grew on me. I loved it more and more every second that went by. That's as good as anything I've ever heard from them. It's infectious. Dude, it's incredible at their age. They're still putting out bangers. That's a banger, dude. That's a good tune.
It's not their best song, but it holds up with some of their good songs, man.
But it's got that pop, and it's got that stones. It's got a solo. It's got the not. It's got all the vocal. Oh, dude, they're still killing it. They are still killing it.
It's so crazy.
Wow. Angry. And don't get angry. I think people need... I think it's a good time in your life when you mature to the age when you can realize that anger is kind of pointless.
Mm-hmm.
And you just kind of have to admit defeat and realize that there's going to be people you disagree with. That's just how it is.
Right.
And that it's not changing. That's never going to change. It's just like, whatever. Let them do whatever the fuck they want. I'm going to do what we want and form micro communities. It's all about micro communities, man. Finding communities that you have things in common with people and just living in that community. That's all you need to do. It's very easy. Mm-hmm. The internet is a big place. You can literally find people from any country in the world to hang it with if you have something to talk about. And stop worrying about the big picture. Worry about the little picture, the neighbors, the old lady down the street whose husband just died. You know, that's what your world should be. Not some macrospective, philosophical remedy to all the world's problems. That's not our deal. Our deal is to take care of the people around us. And the Rolling Stones, I feel, do that on a level that is so perfect. I love when a band generates these thoughts out of me, because it's just like, that was fucking worth it. Mm-hmm. It's like, that was fucking worthwhile listening to.
I loved it, man.
That's a 10. I loved it. It's like my new favorite song. It's fantastic. At first the chorus I thought was a little poppy, but then they take it right back into the like gritty rock and roll verses.
Yeah.
But a pop chorus. That's crazy. That's a 10. That's a 10. 10 out of 10.
Yeah, man. I loved it. I loved it. Everything sounded great. The drums were perfect. The little riff was perfect. Oh, man. Such a good sound. Such a good feel to it, right? And then it's called Angry, but then it's like a happy tune, you know? So, like, the difference is kind of cool there, too. I'm going to give it a 10, too. I loved it, man.
Dude, think about that. Think about how insane that is. It's a feel-good song talking about how you should be angry.
Right.
Like, it's the best thing. It's like the world needs this right now, you know? Like, this is what they need to hear. Fucking A. Okay, I'm going to loop this commercial. I'll interrupt it. I just got to take a quick whiz. But we'll loop a commercial. We'll get into the next one. We got punk rock, or skate punk. What are we calling it? Skater punk. We got skater punk. So we're going to take a little break, everybody. This next segment is the best. Let's listen to it.